Welcome back, everyone, to the latest episode in the ongoing adventures of Stigwell, the Sith Inquisitor, my sorcerer build, which we have been using for these chapters. I've been publishing these at 5 p.m. Central Time, alternating between this and the smuggler side, so that we're not doing only darkness and despair, but also something fun and lighthearted with the smuggler. So regardless of which one of those episodes you're following along with, thank you so much for the support for those of you who have been following along. Don't forget that not only are we doing this in episodic format, covering each one of the main quests in a chapter format, but eventually we will be publishing everything from a planet in a total planetary walkthrough. So for example, this being the planet of Korriban, eventually I'll be combining all of these intro episodes into a planet Korriban walkthrough. But in the meantime, the latest episode here, we are working on this mission, which is martial law. I think we're going to be doing more than just this mission because this is going to be a really quickie. I think we're just supposed to report up to the second floor of the Sith Academy to speak to the training master. This used to be important because you used to have to train your abilities, but you no longer have to train your abilities because they're given to you automatically as of the legacy of the Sith expansion. So I think this will just be a quick turn in, and then we'll be on to the next quest. So this will be one of those exceptions where we're not just doing a single quest for the episode. In any case, like, subscribe, and hit that bell icon so you never miss an update as we continue this adventure. Support if you can with Super Chats on the live streams and premieres. Super thanks on uploads and YouTube shorts. And of course, memberships here on the channel. Starting at $2.99 a month, we do some private videos and fun stuff for our community members. Plus, we have a Patreon page. You can support there as well. Plus, you get access to our point-and-click adventure game, fantasy book series, and our tabletop game, and the Discord if you want to come hang out with us and play games.
Hello there, friend. You remember my brother and me from downstairs? With Harkon, right?
Sorry it had to be this way.
We don't like it any more than you do. Well, maybe a little more.
Now, you really don't know whether I like this or not.
I'm sorry, man. I liked you. I really did.
But Harkon made us a deal, see? We kill you, we go home.
If you're going to kill me, then do it.
I'm sorry. I really am.
Quiet, Balak. The time for talk is past. Fight for your life, acolyte.
Nothing like roast pansy for breakfast. Oh, he literally sent me up here just to face those guys to die. What an ass. We're about to have a little chat with Harkon. I can't wait to stifle this guy. It's gonna be just sweet, sweet revenge.
Well, well. Look who shows up at long last. I half expected to hear you'd crossed some Dark Lord upstairs and finally got yourself killed. None of the others have shown up either. I assume they're dead by now, which means you and Fawn are the last ones.
So I just killed Fawn and I'm Sith, right? This shouldn't take long.
Wrong. Your final trial will be to retrieve an ancient map from the innermost chamber of Naga Sado's tomb, which has never been breached in thousands of years. But before you get the map, you'll have to awaken an ancient assassin called a Dashard that sleeps in the tomb. You cannot access the map without him, understand?
What's so special about this map?
Lord Zash wants it. Oh, and one more thing. You'll be competing with Fawn for this map. Whoever brings it back will be Lord Zash's apprentice. The other will die. And Fawn's already started, so my advice? Run, slave. Run.
One moment, please.
Lord Zash, what are you doing here?
Overseer, are you implying that I, a Lord of the Sith, don't have the right to go where I please within the Academy of the Sith?
No, of course not, Lord Zash.
Good. I saw the last acolyte arrive. I wanted to see the hopefuls off on their final trial. Where's, the red one, Fawn?
He finished his trial early, so I sent him on rather than keeping him waiting for this
Pity. I just finished translating the wonderful text this acolyte brought from Tulakhord's tomb, and it's most illuminating. I don't know that the map can be retrieved without it.
Uh-oh. Fawn's in trouble.
It's too late. Fawn's already left. You can't just...
Give one acolyte an unfair advantage over the other? Overseer, when has being Sith ever been about being fair? Now,
sweet acolyte,
here is what you must do to free the Dashad. There are rods scattered throughout the tomb of Naga Sado. These rods are the keys to the chamber where the ancient assassin is imprisoned. You will need to place the rods in the chamber door and electrify them. I don't know exactly the reason, but it is clear that you will not be able to retrieve the map without the Dashad. But be careful. He is very dangerous.
I have yet to meet a danger I cannot defeat.
I will return when both acolytes are back from the tomb. You will not do anything further to affect the outcome of the trial. Understood?
Yes, Lord Zash.
Good. And good luck, acolyte.
Well, I gotta say, I'm liking the fact that Lady Zash is taking a liking to me. I don't normally go in for blondes, but you know, I can make an exception. And also, I'm gonna thumb my nose at Overseer Harkin on the way out. Neener, neener, neener. Yeah, that was 6 minutes to complete that quest, so we're definitely doing this one. And we'll probably title the episode A Map for the Future, since that's what this is the main quest for. So, off we go, and we will of course be picking up any side quests we see along the way, as we always do. Back to the tombs, the Valley of the Dark Lords. Ooh, are we going up that elevator? Looks like we might be doing. Nope, we're not. We're going a little farther down. Oop, there's a side quest.
Acolyte, may I speak to you for a moment?
I love her armor.
For a beauty like yourself, of course.
Oh, yes. Thank you. You're too kind, really. There was another acolyte, not long ago, who entered this tomb and did not come back. He died in there.
And you were worried to see a handsome man like me die too?
No, I mean, not that... But that's not what I meant. I mean, it's just that the acolyte who went in there, he was a good sort, friendly and talkative. He said he was entering the tomb to prove himself to his father. I just thought it would be nice if somebody took his body back and told his father he didn't make it.
Ooh, you've got legs. Okay.
Yes, the father should be told that his son has fallen.
I'd never survive in there. And even if I did, I wouldn't be allowed to see his father. He is a Dark Honor Guard stationed in the Academy. None but Sith can ever set foot on the sacred ground where he stands watch. But okay. You could find the body and bring it to his father. Please, do this and honor the fallen.
This Dark Honor Guard better make it worth my while.
Thank you so much. If you find the acolyte's remains inside the tomb, let me know. I can tell you where to find his father in the Academy. Good luck.
Alright, so, side quest into the tomb of Naga Sado. Oh, hello, I bet we have a mission to kill all you guys. Yep. A little bit of thunder, a little bit of lightning. Alright, there's acolyte's remains. And we have a side quest.
Who let you down deadly?
Koshlegike. strange creature.
What exactly are you? Could you try to explain things from the beginning? What happened then?
Sounds like not a me problem, sounds like a you problem.
If Prythor's the one who exiled you to these caves, I doubt he'll change his mind about feeding you. If Prythor is really behind all this, he may be worth investigating.
Should I really help the creature? Let's go speak to the Overseer first and see what's up with that.
You found him. That poor acolyte.
He got torn up pretty badly in there.
He was so brave and ready to prove himself to his father. His father was Naaman Fall. If you take the acolyte's remains to his father, I'm sure he'll be grateful.
Okay.
I suppose it's always good to make powerful friends.
You can find the acolyte's father outside the chamber of the Dark Council.
Alright, well, we need to talk to the Overseer anyway. Let's take a gander, shall we?
What do you want? I'm training slaves to feed the beasts, and I don't have time to chat.
Have you heard of a creature called Serun?
Serun? You know of Serun? That creature was close to me when I was an acolyte. It helped me survive my trials. It traveled places I couldn't, told me everything it heard and saw. It had been living off vermin before I came along. I figured out a way to make it healthier, stronger. Serun's special meals.
By all means, continue.
Serun never knew exactly what I fed it. Its meals weren't just beast fodder. Serun ate the corpses of the Academy's failures, the bones and blood of dead acolytes.
That just got a little creepy.
Feeding on their energy after death, it grew exponentially more powerful with every meal, and became strong in the dark side.
No good can come of this.
Pity I didn't have your insight at the time. When I saw how twisted Serun was becoming, I sent it away. It was becoming hungrier all the time, and I feared it would attack the living. Destroying it seemed impossible. It could heal any injury it suffered. I hoped it would find a new home somewhere, but it seems we must act more decisively.
What's your plan?
Aid Serun, and it will turn on us. One more taste of power, and it will begin hunting acolytes. I can't allow that. Together, we must poison Serun. Before I sent Serun away, I developed a powerful toxin, but I didn't have the heart to use it. It won't kill the creature, but it should strip it of its power.
So let's say we poison it. What happens to Serun then?
My best guess? If we do this, Serun won't survive much longer. It will hide as best it can and slowly starve. But the alternative is to let it become a living horror.
Then let's poison that thing.
I'm glad you see it as I do.
That's weird how that's a light side option.
I'm giving you this meat. Don't ask me where it came from, but it should fool Serun. Once the poison is in its system, it will weaken. I take no satisfaction in this, but it is necessary.
Interesting. Alright, upstairs for the next one. I hear a holocron. I thought I heard a holocron. I know there was a disco disc in one of those rooms that we already clicked on. That might have been what I was hearing. It wasn't a true holocron. It was a informational disc. There's a lore thing.
You don't belong here. You stand before the Chamber of the Dark Council, and this floor is off limits to all who are not lords of the Sith. If you are not on official business, you will leave now.
I've come with news about your son.
So that is the smell you carry. It is said he went into the tomb of Naga Sadao to prove himself, and was killed. He was such a weak boy. He shames me in death as he shamed me in life. When I heard of his death, I could not leave my post. Honor forbade it. Still, I would like to know what happened in there.
Tell me what happens around here first. Must be pretty crazy.
This is where the Dark Council meets, where Sith politics play out, where the Emperor issues his decrees, and where lives are destroyed with the flick of a wrist. Satisfied? Now tell me, where did you find his body? Did my pathetic son even make it past the first steps? In the end, was he Sith?
Man, that's a hard one. Like, he doesn't appear to have any sympathy at all, so why would I lie and give him a better feeling? I really don't know.
He died right at the entrance to the tomb. Pathetic indeed.
Of course he did. Every moment of his life existed only to mock me. I will keep his bones to remind me of my shame and to focus my anger. But you have done me a service, and such deeds should be repaid. You have brought me pain and torment. I will return the favor. My son sought a relic I placed in the base of a cracked statue, deep in the tomb. This crystal will release it. Now go.
So this is a strange case of quests that sent me to the tomb, had me come back, and then send me back to the tomb. Usually it's two-way, not three-way. So I'm glad I chose to run back and turn these in before finishing the main quest. This is why we do the walkthroughs, so that you can hopefully follow along and not make any mistakes, and get the most expedient path to fortune and glory. Oh, I just can't wait to get my lightsaber. Sweet, sweet lightsabers. Flick of the wrist and the wom-wom-wom-wom. It's gonna be good when it happens. We should probably go ahead and take care of you guys for the quest. Acolyte. For the power of the dark side.
I'm sure you'll find it satisfactory.
Nom nom
nom.
Don't say thank you or anything. You just need to learn to deal.
First, Rod of Despair. Okay. To the base of a statue, so that's gonna be right here. Nice. Not better than what I have, but a worthy contribution. Background music is hauntingly creepy, which is a nice touch. Now it got uncreepy. Like we're watching a Star Trek movie in the Kelvin Crusade. That music cut all. Alright, we're good now. take the rod of... Which one is this? The rod of wrath. A rod of ruin. Crispy droids. Alright. Place the rods at their altars. Oh, hello, Lucas. What's up, buddy? My kitty cat's coming over to say hi. Thought you were in the other chair. Sit on Daddy's lap. What's up? Are you asking me to move so that you can sit behind me? Alright. Okay, don't claw at my back, you little noobs. Good thing you guys don't have me on camera, I just had to... like completely sit up in my chair so that he could sit behind me because he got all cranky. I want my chair! Too bad I can't punt this guy. Maybe I can. Oh, I missed the edge. So who's the guy suspended in lightning? That's what I need to know. That's a long way down. I really want to punt one of these guys off. Woohoo! Hashtag worth it. Companion gifts, we're gonna hold on to those. Better hold on to these two just in case I want these for cosmetics later. By the way, how's my character specced by default? Lightning? Yeah, I'm happy with lightning. Lightning sounds good. Shit, I need to... Doesn't give off a Prometheus vibe, not at all. Are we sure we're in the Star Wars universe and not the Aliens universe? About to find out what's inside the tomb beyond that door. Conduit of power. Power of the dark side.
Places Amin's Waihai's fools. Go. Taukita, Melaswe Sama, Word Sign In, Merem Nai, Saigatrawa Digda, Chagasar Jais, and Barks, Prize War Pere.
Your defiance is foolish and misplaced.
Ababarna Habens, Cloud Bena, Ni in Usakwai, Was Jabe, Wise Jabe, Prophetess, Wis.
Shut up. You are my slave now.
Was Jabe, Wise Jabe, Prophetess, Wisans Jagara Haitain.
Oh, we'll see about that.
We deal Dubai's Quibans mana. Twade in Warpai and Parlai Kain.
Gonna eat my face. Oh, I can't punt him.
Ni ok panai, name in my dens. Ipsik by Gunana, Jaus by Rojandan, in Bise Wistai. In Bizose Waitai Spila Presin Kretai, in Bise Ewanata, Atragata Injais.
I am your master. Get used to it.
Sisunja.
So, is this my first companion? He's threatening me. Someday he's gonna regain his strength. Oh, snap, did he just. Okay, I thought he took a swing at me. Let's have him be a tank. I'm not a big fan of my first companion, to be honest with you, a big ugly brute. But whatevs. I never stick with the first companion anyway. Although I did in the case of... No, I didn't even in the case of that one. Okay, I was thinking my Jedi Knight, but the first one is a droid. I did stick with the droid. Or I did not stick with the droid. Sorry, I went with the Kira. Yeah.
fighters.
Right, he is very satisfactory as a tank. That was a nice fight. Alright, it's awfully nice to be able to sit back here and shoot lightning at something. Not gonna lie. Oh, what is that big nasty thing? Is that a galaxy map back there? I don't know, but we're gonna send him in. Is this target not an enemy? It is. Not taking a lot of damage. Move up on it, maybe. Killed that, which is worthy. Oh, by the way, is this only a small influence gain? I don't really care about gaining influence with this dude, to be honest with you. That is a galaxy map. Turn to the Overseer Harkoon. Do we have enough coin to recall back? Because it's expensive to recall now. 723? That's not too bad. I've been doing all the side quests. Somebody gave me a million credits the other day on my Jedi Consular. I arrived on Coruscant with my new character. I did that stream the other day, and off stream I moved the character to Coruscant and had ran up to the Jedi Temple the Senate building, I should say, to do a turn-in. And there was a dude handing out travel fees to everybody out front. He was like literally just giving a million credits to everybody he saw. And he was talking in general chat that he was doing it to help people with the new travel fees. I was like, that's awesome, dude. Community is still at large here in Star Wars Republic. Maybe not on the dark side of the Empire, but in the Republic side, yes. Still some good peeps.
I'm telling you, Overseer, it cannot be done. I went into the tomb, I saw the Dashard across the chasm, but I could not get to it.
But the map! Lord Zash is adamant she will not take an apprentice without the map!
I'm telling you, Lord Zash wants the impossible. No one is ever going to get that map!
You don't mean this map, do you?
The map! And the Dashard! Get that monster out of here this instant! And give me the map!
Not gonna happen,
no,
bro.
No, it's not possible. You wretch, you filth, you must have cheated somehow. How did you do it? How did you release the monster?
Sei Galutsaida, Iswis us Ulfgnden, Ja Atnam, in Puidangarja.
And I am hungry. That's awesome.
Right. You must have cheated. You must have. You'll pay for this!
Oh, I think you need to have a feast.
For patience. You will have your chance at this whelp after you personally deliver this map to Lord Zash.
Eat them both, Ken.
Dobila Wesum.
Keep your pet at bay for just a moment, Acolyte. I would have a word with Fon.
Lord Zash?
Yes, Fon. Now, where's my map?
Here, Lord Zash.
Right here.
You found it for me, Fawn? How wonderful.
He couldn't have found it if he tried.
Silence! Fawn will tell me what happened, won't you, Fawn? You wouldn't dare lie to me, would you? Because it would be a shame for me to discover that you lied to me. Now, one more time. Did you bring this map back from Nagasado's tomb?
No, I didn't. I'm sorry.
Hearken, you fool. In any other group for any other lord, this young man would have torn the other acolytes to shreds. What were you trying to prove? That you could outsmart me? That you knew better than me what kind of person I wanted for an apprentice? You fool! There's your pet, Hearken. Clean this mess up. Apprentice, meet me in my chambers upstairs.
As you say.
This is not the end. Without Lord Zash to save you, you're nothing.
Do I get to
crush
him? I
have connections that will hunt you wherever you go.
That's big talk for a worm like you.
Get out of my sight, slave. Your new master is waiting for you upstairs.
Smells like burnt fawn. Now I'm in the mood for tacos. Ooh, we're going to get up to Lady Zash's personal chambers. Nudge, nudge, wink, wink. I doubt they'll give her the option to get with my master, but you know, would be kind of cool. Kind of barren in here, lady.
Ah, my magnificent new apprentice. Congratulations are in order, I believe.
Thank you for giving me this opportunity.
You've earned it, my apprentice. Now, I was just looking over this astonishing map you brought back, and I can tell we have a lot of work ahead of us.
Murder and mayhem await.
Patience, my apprentice. We must go about this with tact. All in good time. You must meet me on Drummond Cars. There we can talk more.
Drummond Cars. Got it.
I will meet you in my chambers in the Citadel in Cars City. There we can speak more freely of the work ahead, without the fear of unfriendly ears.
Oh, somebody's spying on us.
This is the lightsaber I have as
my first lightsaber! My first lightsaber!
I want you to have it.
She chucks it to me across the desk. Oh, it feels good.
I am honored.
Excellent. I'm glad you like it. It served me well. Now, remember, my chambers, the Citadel, Drummond Cars. It's imperative that we get to work on this as soon as possible.
Well, who are you three? Harkin's men?
Stop right there, slave. Darth Scotia has a message for you.
Give me the message.
The message is this. You will not go to Drummond Cars. Everything you've done here, everyone you've dealt with, Lord Zash included, is insignificant. Darth Scotia has eyes and ears on Korriban. He knows what your master is up to, and he is displeased, to say the least. On Korriban, Lord Zash may have her way, but on Drummond Cars, it's a different story. So you see, you have to die.
Kem, what is it you do to Force users again?
Gibai Iswis Aman Hanguijins.
Ortosin, is that a Dashard? Maybe this isn't such a good idea.
Coward! Fight, you fool!
Guess what, guys? Time to test my new lightsaber. No! Hang on! Got windows open enough that I don't want to open them.
Sight is like.
Alright. Mission complete. So I get these and I get to choose a reward. So what can I choose to make him look like? Green. Ooh, he's a little bigger. Okay, no, it's just all the same size. Red, green, or multi-hued. I kind of like that one right there, to be honest with you. I don't want the green. The multi-hue is not bad. Honestly, though, I think I like that blood red. Okay, first things first. We need to mod this saber. And equip this. That. Oh yeah. And can I, how do I just, did I do that from straight from here? Count with companion. Aha! I don't have the subscription status to make his customization. So save that for later. If I do decide to sub at some point. Now technically, we can get one more mod here over at the station. It's the old item modification quest, which gives one more mod for our lightsaber. Well, we are done with Drahman Kos, ladies and gentlemen. Excuse me, Korriban. We're off to Drahman Kos. I can learn how to form coherent thoughts. Done with Korriban, ready to move to Drahman Kos. So, the cool thing is I'll be able to go out now and take these quests videos and combine them together to create a final version, which will be the whole of Drahman Kos. Why did I say Drahman Kos again? Because I'm looking at it and it's in my brain. Korriban. Korriban. Alright, install the mod. I don't think any of these are things I need for cosmetic purposes. Alright, so we need to take a shuttle to the Imperial Fleet, and from there we'll be heading to Drahman Kos. So, that is the end of this episode. So, if you've been following along and enjoying the episodes of Stigwell the Sith, Inquisitor, Sorcerer, please like, subscribe, and hit that bell icon so you never miss an update, because we are going to be doing the entirety of the Sith Inquisitor storyline. Our next planet is Drahman Kos. I'll be doing the same thing for Drahman Kos. I'll be doing episodes for each one of the main quests. Usually it's one episode per quest, occasionally two if they're shorter quests, and then in between we are doing all the side quests, and then I will compile all of those at the end for a complete and total walkthrough of Drahman Kos, which I will be doing for Korriban today with this, so you'll want to make sure to stay tuned for that as well. Plus, I'm doing the Smuggler at the same time, so I'm alternating. Usually I do like an episode of the Inquisitor today, an episode of the Smuggler tomorrow, and so on and so forth, so we get a nice little balance between light and dark. So hopefully you'll tune into those as well. Please support if you can, because it does help me do this full-time, keeps me here at the desk rather than out and about and doing other things. So if you like the content that I produce, drop a super thanks on this video. There's a button down below over on the right hand side below which allows you to just plug in whatever amount that YouTube has pre-programmed, but you can choose your own as well. You can also do super thanks on any YouTube short you see from me. You can also do super chats on any live stream or premiere you see. So if you're watching this during the premiere, that's how you contribute there, or you can join as a member of the channel with three different tiers. It's a great monthly way to support me here as well. Plus, we have a Patreon page with my wife and my brother. If you want to get into what we're doing game dev wise, we have a tabletop game, point and click adventure game, and a book series that are all part of the same world. And there is a Discord if you want to come hang out with us and join us. We are on the Starforge server, and we are looking towards getting some more people together for the Alliance side, for the Republic, to get together a ship and everything. We play on Thursdays, usually myself and Mujin, so if you want to come hang out there, you can. We also do like Valheim on Saturdays and some stuff like that, so Fridays, I should say. Anyway, folks, thanks so much for tuning in today. I'll be seeing you in the next episode. Until then, stay safe, and may the Force be with you.